Hello students, welcome to Analog Circuits Laboratory. Myself V. Naresh, Lab Assistant, Department of ECE. Following are the list of experiments and design and verification of voltage series and current series feedback amplifiers. And this series feedback circuit diagram. It is the voltage series feedback amplifier. It is the voltage dependent voltage source, and the negative feedback reduces the amplifier and gain by factor of 1 plus beta A. And here this is the voltage series feedback is the negative feedback amplifier. Here the advantages of negative feedback amplifiers are the bandwidth will also increase, the noise and distortion will decreases, the stability will increase, and the proper impedances matching. Impedances matching will different in different amplitudes amplifiers. The disadvantage of the negative feedback amplifier is the gain is decreases. Okay, now here the types of the negative feedback amplifiers are voltage series feedback amplifier and current series feedback amplifier, voltage shunt feedback amplifier and current shunt feedback amplifier. And here this is the first we discuss in the voltage series feedback amplifiers. And here this is the voltage series feedback amplifiers. These are characteristics of the voltage series, current shunt and voltage shunt. Here feedback signal is in voltage series and current series is voltage, current shunt is current, the voltage shunt is current. Okay, now these are formulas. Here the gain equal to A equal to X naught by X1, means here the in voltage series AV equal to V naught by VE. In current series, here current series feedback amplifier is called as a transconductance amplifier. The GM, the transconductance amplifier gain equal to I naught by VI. Here in current series amplifier, the input is voltage, the output is current. Okay, na? In voltage series, input is voltage, output also voltage. In current shunt, the output is current, input also current. In voltage shunt, output is voltage, input is current. Okay, na? And next go to the circuit diagram. And this is the voltage series feedback circuit diagram. Here, the input is voltage, output also voltage. Okay, na? The same circuit is connected above the breadboard. And next go to the switch on the power supply, DC power supply, that is VCC is 12 volts. And next go to the function generator and switch on it. And here the amplitude is 500 millivolts and frequency. Okay, now you can starting from and first go to frequencies 10 hertz. Starting frequencies 10 hertz, amplitude is 500 millivolts, and observe the output here. Approximately 1 into 208 millivolts. Okay, na? Next go to the, for example, go to the 70 millihertz, 70 hertz, and here change the frequency up to 70 hertz. Here output is 434 millivolts in 70 hertz, 434 millihertz. Next go to the here constant, for example go to the 1 kilohertz. 1 kilohertz. Tap it here.
voltage is 444 millivolts. In one case, 444 millivolts. Next, go to the 100 kilohertz. Here also 460 millivolts, 448 R. Triple 4 millivolts in 100 kilohertz. Next go to the 1 mega. In omega 452 millivolts or 440 millivolts. Next go to the here maximum voltage is 10 mega. Here 10 mega is 636 millivolts or 640 millivolts. Next go to the 20 megahertz or 15 megahertz. Here output is 480 millivolts, that is 15 megahertz. Next increase the 20 megahertz. Okay, 316 millivolts. Okay, now these are output voltages. And find out the gain. Gain equal to V out by V in. Here V in is 500 millivolts. These are gain values. And gain in dB is 20 log of V out by V in. This is the gain values. And draw the graph. Frequency versus gain. Okay, no? This is the voltage series feedback amplifier. Here the lower cutoff frequency is 50 kHz and upper cutoff frequency is 60 MHz. Lower cutoff frequency is 50 kHz, higher cutoff frequency is 60 MHz. The bandwidth equal to 15.95 MHz. Okay, now this is the voltage series feedback amplifier. And the next go to the current series feedback amplifier. And this is the circuit diagram for current series feedback amplifier. This is the transconductance feedback amplifier. Here the input is voltage and the output is current. And here also called as a current to voltage converter. And in this, the current series feedback amplifier, the same circuit is connected upon the breadboard. Okay, now the same circuit is connected upon the breadboard. And here switch on the power supply. And next go to the, and here the amplitude is 1 volt and frequency is starting from 10 hertz. Switch on it. And next go to the, observe the output waveform in CRO. And this is the output waveform. Just stop it here and find out the voltages. That is, okay, no? Here the 33.60 millivolts. Okay, na? Here approximately 37 or 33. Next go to the 20 hertz and increase the frequency and observe the output here. Just stop it here. 120 Hz 66 milliwatts, approximately 64. Okay, next increase the 1 kHz. 1 kHz. Let's stop it here. Here voltage is 311.2 millivolts. Okay, nah? One case 112 millivolts approximately. Next go to the 100 kHz. Just run it and stop it here. Output is 112.2 means 112 millivolts. Next increase the frequency is 1 mega. Here is 114 millivolts or 110. Next increase the 10 mega. Okay, now approximately 97.60, 98 millivolts, 10 mega. Next increase the 15 mega. Mega 90 millivolts. Next increase the 20 megahertz. Seventy-five point two zero or 80 millivolts and 20 megahertz. Okay, now these are, here input voltage is 1 volt and output voltage are this. You can increase the frequency starting from 10 hertz to 20 megahertz. These are output values, and find out the gain equal to V out by V in, and these are gain values, and in gain in dB equal to 20 lakh of V out by V in. These are in decibels values gain. Okay, now. And the same values to substitute to draw the waveform. Okay, now these are current series feedback amplifier, and here the lower cutoff frequency is 30 hertz, the higher cutoff frequency is 20 megahertz, approximately bandwidth equal to 20 megahertz. Okay, now this is current series feedback amplifier. Okay, thank you.